Hello, gorgeous. That ain't gonna do it.
I'll get this to wardrobe.
How about a little courage? Who are you now? Are you something more than you were? Stronger for your touch. Did I give you too little? Am I loving you too much?
Let's get you dressed.
You ever feel like there are ghosts watching you?
It's just nerves.
Who? Me? Nervous? Of course nervous. First day on a new job, your heart races to let you know you're alive.
And then it kills you.
Too bad you've got a show to do.
Thank God I've got a show to do.
She'll get to work and settle right down. Fanny's been making a living on the stage since she was 10, 12,
14.
Sold. Did you say something? I wasn't listening.
Enough, keep it still.
She
must shine in every detail, like a ring you buy in retail. Be a standard size that fits a standard dress.
Or to faces that could cause you to have temporary nausea. Do I have to hear a lecture such as that? Is a nose with deviation such a crime against the nation? Should I throw her into jail or drown the cat? So she's built a bit of balance, she possesses both talents. Or is that pill too bitter to digest? Ignore the dragons.
Don't you worry, Mrs. Straycosh. One day the whole world will look at me and be stunned.
Go! Toy, break the leg, kid.
From the top.
Sorry, once he makes up his mind, there's no talking to him.
Listen, it's not as his fault. Suppose all he had for breakfast was onion rolls. And then in the morning, someone drops a bagel on your plate. You'd say, what the heck is that? That's me. I'm a bagel on a plate full of onion rolls.
Something else, all right.
Listen, I've got 36 expressions. Sweet as pie to Chuck's leather. And that's 6 expressions more than all them Barrymores put together. Instead of just kicking me, why won't they give me a lift? I think it's a plot, because they're scared that I got such a gift. A long gift. Because I'm the greatest star. I am by far. No one knows. And wait, they're gonna hear a voice. A silver flute. Yoo-hoo, yoo-hoo. They'll cheer for each tune. And you know, that kid is terrific. When I expose it. Now can't you see to look at me that I'm
Just think, Eddie, you woke up this morning and the world was a wonderful place, bright and shiny, full of possibility and promise. And then you met my daughter.
You know, huh?
I live with it.
Oh, come on, Eddie, take me through it one more time.
You go home, Mr. Ryan. I'll handle her.
Good night, Mrs. Price. See you tomorrow, Eddie.
Cute guy. Hmm? Now, to bed. Save something for the paying customers. What?
You think they're gonna like me, Mama?
Are you kidding? You're gonna slay them.
Think so?
I know so. Ask me a guess, Ben. Who's the best?
Notice.
What the?
Woo! Some dates with don't. So today wearing a trench coat, tomorrow wearing pants.
Good job, ladies, but I got a few notes.
Save them for rehearsal.
Is that any way to talk to your boss? Give them to me now, Eddie, while I'm too tired to hear you.
Hey, Eddie, you see that? They liked me.
That was pretty good, huh?
Look, I got all these in my report card, which I never did. Oh, Eddie, how do I ever thank you?
We ought to celebrate. What you doing after the show Saturday night?
You asking me out?
I'm asking what you're doing after the show Saturday night.
Well, if you want to sit around and kibitz, that's fine.
And if it was something more?
Come on, Eddie, you're a terrific guy. But we both know how this goes. Maybe we fool around a little. We have a couple of laughs, a couple of tears. And then one of us is saying we're better off as friends. So how about we skip the melodrama and go right to the last reel?
Good for me. I made a friend. Go change. I'll take you to Brooklyn. Maybe I'll get lucky and your mother will be home.
Thanks, kid.
You ought to give the guy a break.
Who, Eddie? He may not be the most exciting item on the menu, but at least he won't keep you up all night with heartburn.
Good job tonight, girls.
Hey, Mr. Keeney, you see that? They liked me.
I don't pay for them to hate you.
I didn't know you were paying me. How much?
I ain't thought about it yet.
Oh, well, whatever it is, I bet it ain't enough.
French handkerchief linen. Goes very limp, though.
Like something out of a magazine. Most of the tailcoats I've seen rented, you know, got stiff shirts.
They should have. This is just a conversation piece.
Oh, sure, I get it. Sorry, I don't get it. I never got past third grade.
It only means something for people to talk about. And I'm certain you learned everything you needed by the third grade.
So you someone I should know?
Not sure yet. If you mean am I an expert on theater, no. But they say I have an eye for what's unique, and you, Miss Bryce, are that. I predict that one day you are going to be a very big star.
You're the first person to say that to me who wasn't a relative.
I won't be the last.
Well, look who's slumming.
I believe this is yours.
Those were some sweet odds.
That was one unfortunate rainstorm.
For you?
My horse is just no good on the sloppy track.
You didn't have to come all the way down here. Your credit's good.
And this is how it got good.
Hey, Mr. Keeney, gotten around to thinking about me yet?
$40 a week. Take it or leave it.
Leave it. I'm offering 65.
Since when you in the biz?
I was asked by one of your competitors to keep my eyes open should I see something special.
I'm something special.
$65 a week, Miss Bryce, plus dinner.
Plus dinner?
What do you say?
75.
85.
90.
100.
110.
Sorry, I wasn't authorized to go above 100. She's all yours for $110 a week.
Plus dinner.
Plus dinner. Congratulations.
$110? $110? I'm practically a millionaire! So who's the competition? How was it? The competitor? Sig Felbright, no, I'm only kidding. Who?
No one.
No one? You mean you were bluffing? Like in a card game?
Yeah.
So what if Keeney had stopped first?
You would have lost the job.
I would have.
I was willing to take that chance.
You were willing. Ain't you something? Wow. Those yours?
I'm minding them for a friend.
I could look like that. In another lifetime.
You're perfect just as you are.
Boy, have you got good manners. to go. They look hungry.
If there's ever anything I can do for you, let me give you my card. I know a lot of people.
Nick Arnstein.
Arnstein? What do you know?
Nick Arnstein. Hotel Astor.
Nicky Arnstein, what a beautiful, beautiful man.
Well, good night, Mr. Arnstein.
Good night, Miss Bryce. And good luck.
Nicky Arnstein, what a beautiful, beautiful fella.
Oh, and tell whoever washes your shirts, a little starch in the last rinse won't go so limp.
I won't forget.
Wearing a full dress formal and not even going to a wedding. What? You never heard of Nick Arnstein? Of course I have! Just now.
The guy's a legend.
A high roller.
He's got his hands in everything. Boxing, racing.
Chorus girls.
I bet he knows Flo Ziegfeld.
He could even know Mr. Wrigley from Spearmint. He's dated a girl from nearly every show on Broadway.
And a few from other avenues. Ditch his card and stick to a nice guy like Eddie.
Nicky Arnstein. Did you see how he had polish on his nails? What are you two glued here? Let's go, I've got a man waiting for me. All you've got waiting is a chicken in the icebox. Nicky Arnstein. I'll never see him again.
Oh, some tells me you ain't seen the last of him yet.
What's she been walking around in, towels? Someday, Eddie, when I have nothing better to do, I will explain to you all about girls.
This is humiliating. You do know that I'm Fanny's boss.
Turn now, boss later.
So what do you think, Eddie? Is it a job or an audition?
It's gotta be a job.
But why wouldn't it say so?
She's right. All the telegram says is, Dear Miss Bryce, stop. I'd like to see you at the New Amsterdam Theater this Thursday at 4 o'clock. Stops on Florence Ziegfeld. By heart like the Pleasure Legions.
So now recite later.
I wonder how a mama came to name a boy Florence.
It's Flo Rins.
Ooh, and that's better?
And it's done.
Wait, gotta put on the fur.
You know what I think? I think someone talked to him about me. There was this guy backstage one night, Nick Arnstein, just the kind of guy to know Ziegfeld.
That was a year ago.
So I could have slipped his mind.
The paper's been printing stuff about you for months, but a telegram arrives and suddenly it's all on account of that schmo?
Yeah, I bet it was him.
This fur has been on God knows how many coats, God knows what else.
Oh, my stomach aches.
Because you're making yourself crazy. Why'd you have to have a new dress now?
I wouldn't be nervous, Mama. Mama, feel my head. Have I got a fever? I think I'm dying.
You're not dying. You're built like a horse.
It's all coming too easy. That's what's got me scared. Where are the setbacks, the suffering an artist is supposed to go through, Mrs. Meeker? Where are the hard knocks? Where's the torture?
Here's the torture. You take that off, and you put that on. Hey, and who says you're gonna get the job anyway, huh? And even if you do, who says you won't get fired in a week?
Oh, thanks.
Cheer up, Fanny. Fanny's always waiting right around the corner.
Greetings and salutations.
You can't say hello like a normal human being?
I brought grapes.
Grapes!
Oh, well, it all's forgiven.
As I was saying, I'm in the taxi on my way home from my married daughter's Sadie's. When I pass by Feeney's Theater, And outside I see a picture of the girl who is opening in the new show. Guess who the girl isn't?
I'll give it a shot. The girl isn't my unmarried daughter, Fanny.
So how come?
Because she ain't in the show.
Aha!
Oh, Sarah Strakosch, when I am worried about my daughter's career, I will send you a telegram like someone sent one to her. My dear Fanny, stop! Please do me a big personal favor and come to the New Amsterdam Theater this Thursday at 4 o'clock in regards to your starring in the new Ziegfeld Follies. Stop! Love and kisses, signed Lorenz Ziegfeld.
The Ziegfeld Follies? In person? Oh, Fanny, darling! Now you belong to the ages! The ages!
Honesty is useless. Have it your way. And as your benefactor, I'm very proud of you.
I did good, huh?
Didn't surprise me. After all, I wrote the card with your flowers before the curtain went up. I hope you like white roses.
Dear Star, I told you so.
If you were a horse, I would have bet on you.
Do your horses always win?
No, but they're always the best on the track. You're very funny. The old-timey accent. Looking at you, You remind me of my grandmother.
Stop, another compliment like that and I won't be able to get my hat on.
What I'm saying is that you and the audience, they trust you like old friends.
Hamisha.
Hamisha?
You sure your name is Arnstein? Hamisha, familiar, comfortable.
That's what it is.
Boy, did we grow up on different sides of the track, huh?
And yet somehow we find ourselves together. So what do we do about it?
We gotta do something.
What's the point of succeeding if you're not going to brag? You need to make the rounds, hit the hot spots, make grand entrances and watch people stare and whisper, that's Ziegfeld's new star. And who is a lucky man with her? I wanna be seen with you on my arm, to wear you like a charm, your glitter decorating my arm. Now naturally such proximity gives rumors to rise. Well, let them analyze what our amalgamation implies. Oh yes, the gossips will press, too willing to stress. The scene is I know what, so what? I wanna be seen with you on my arm. Let's give this town a light.
Waiting on me. I gotta go. You
want to
come with me?
I'd love to.
You don't mean it.
Of course I do. It's not every night that an actual verified, glorified Ziegfeld girl invites me to Brooklyn.
I wouldn't want to waste your evening.
How can I? When I'll be with you. Just gotta be
Feldstein.
Nice to... Brother Sherman, help!
Thank you, Mama.
What did I say? What?
You said something charming. You must be very proud of your daughter.
Well, I'm proud of all my children. My son, Lou. My other daughter, Carol.
All right, let's put these in order.
I'm Mrs. Straycosh.
How do you do? I'm Nick Arnstein. I'm a friend of Miss Price.
Oh. Would you perhaps like to join us in a little poker game? A friendly little 3-cent limit.
Three, did you say?
I'm Mrs. Meeker.
A pleasure.
Your deal.
And here I worried about bringing him home.
You never worried about bringing me home.
He's not from the neighborhood.
Neither am I.
Well, I guess a gentleman fits in anywhere.
Fanny! Oh, that Mr. Arnstein. The way he looks at home. I got a feeling this isn't his first poker game.
A gentleman fits in anywhere.
So does a sponge. Stranger ought to act a little strange.
You think he's good looking?
Gorgeous. Oh. If you fall for that type of thing, I did. Reminds me of Fanny's papa, my ex, also gorgeous, and wherever he is, he should only stay there.
You don't find him a little slick?
Eddie, there are men who should be pursued, there are men who should be avoided. Guess which ones usually get the girl, huh?
Well, that's 57 cents to you and 39 to you, and worth every penny.
Fine bunch of crooks I introduced you to.
Oh, we're just more in practice is all. Oh, Fanny, I'm so happy for your success. Only one thing could make me happier. To dance at your wedding. Oh. Sit, children, sit. Talk a little.
Should I wait until the party's over or kill her now?
Now?
No. I love Mrs. Straycosh. And if you knew how hard I had to work to let her win 57 cents, I had to cheat. I've been waiting all night to be alone with you.
Congratulations, Fanny! I was busy with the baby before! Thank you, Mrs. Nadler.
Alone with you and a block full of your intimates.
Around here, you're never alone. All I did tonight was open on Broadway. You want to see real excitement? Wait till I break a fingernail. Funny, I've imagined you practically every place in the world. London, Paris, but... Henry Street? Never.
You've imagined me?
Maybe it was the ruffled shirt. Like a character out of a book, and I haven't read so many books, so it's your turn. Say something.
Would you say you're a woman of wide experience?
About what?
Men.
Men. Thousands. On the other side of the footlights. I haven't got time for that nonsense. How about you, hundreds of girls, right?
Merely dozens. Nothing serious. I like feeling free.
You can get lonesome being that free.
You can get lonesome being that busy.
Who would think to look at us? That we got the same problem. We travel single. Maybe we're lucky. But I don't know. Them just let one kid fall down and seven mothers faint. I guess we're both happy, but maybe we ain't. People who need children, meeting others. A feeling deep in your soul says you were half, now you're whole. No more hunger and thirst. But first, be a person who needs people.
I wish I could get to know you better.
Give me 6 good reasons, why not?
Just 1. I have to catch a train for Kentucky early in the morning.
What's in Kentucky?
Half interest in a little farm. I breed horses.
Why, they can't do it themselves? Hey, are you packed? What are you sitting here for? It's practically morning.
If you hadn't been such a success tonight, I would have asked you to come with me. Too bad, really.
Oh, I don't know, but with an opening night and an indecent proposal. It wasn't decent, wasn't it?
Completely.
Oh, thank God. I can tell Mrs. Straykosh things are looking up.
May I call you when I get back?
You dial, they ring.
Number 1 admirer, Nick Arnstein.
You think she'll go?
If she doesn't, I will.
I'll ring for you, Paul, when we're ready to order.
Very good, sir. And may I say, Mr. Arnstein, it's a pleasure to have you back in Baltimore.
Thank you, Paul. I wasn't sure you'd come.
That makes two of us.
Can I take your wrap? That color is wonderful with your eyes.
Just my right eye. I hate what it does to the left. You're planning on making advances?
It does seem possible.
Before or after dinner?
You look beautiful.
Ugh, you don't gotta make that leading lady dialogue with me. I'm a comic.
On stage.
That's where I live. On stage.
Then you're missing a lot.
You can't have it all.
Of course you can, if you insist on it.
Hey, somebody laid a blue egg on the table.
I picked it up in Europe ages ago. It's one of my favorite things. I thought you might like it. It's marble.
Blue marble egg, white roses. You went to a lot of trouble for someone you weren't sure would show up.
I hoped you would, just as I hope you like dry carrot.
I wouldn't know dry from wet.
Are you going to be all right?
Oh, please, I was raised in a saloon, remember?
What are you so angry about?
Ah, who's angry? Oh, I'm sorry if you're disappointed. But what did you expect? You think just because we happen to be in the same city, you ask me out to dinner and I fall all over you? You may have been my first ruffled shirt, but I met plenty of you kind since. You're not slumming here.
I never was, and you know it.
Don't holler at me.
I'm not hollering, you are.
Oh, well, that's different. I'm a natural hollerer. I'm not that kid from Keeney's anymore. I used to impress very easy. I'm a little older now.
Funny, you seem much younger. About eight, I'd say. A bad-tempered eight-year-old who hasn't had her supper.
Well then, get me my supper.
When I passed the theater and I saw you were here, I lit up like a Christmas tree.
Oh, because of great big wonderful me.
Don't make fun of yourself, Fanny. Don't. And yes, it was because of great big wonderful you.
So how come I haven't heard from you? You missed my last two opening nights.
I didn't miss a one.
You didn't come backstage.
Because you scare me to death.
Maybe we should, order dinner.
If you're sure you're going to stay.
While I'm here, I might as well eat.
Very sensible. I think we're ready now, Paul.
Caviar to begin with, Mr. Ornstein.
Pâté Strasbourg, I think. Then a filet de boeuf, sauce bordelaise, pomme de terre soufflé, endive, and stemmed strawberries, and a very light Bordeaux with the filet.
Salt Emilio, 1905.
Perfect.
Thank you, Mr. Ornstein.
All right.
I would have ordered roast beef and potatoes.
I did.
If I can't tell when you're ordering roast beef, how will I know when you're making advances?
Oh, you'll know. You are woman, I am man. You are smaller, so I can be taller than. You are softer to the touch. It's a feeling I like feeling very much. You are someone I admire. Still, our friendship leaves something to be desired. Does it take more explanation than this? You are woman, I am man. Let's kiss.
Isn't this the height of nonchalance? Furnishing a bed Two good girls do just what mama says when mama's not around. It's a feeling, boy, they, what a feeling.
A bit of pate?
I drink it all day. Should I do the things he'll tell me to? In this pickle, what would Sadie do? In my soul, I feel a little lack. Just suppose he wants his dear back.
Does it take more explanation than this?
Just some dried up toast and a sliver on the top of a chop a liver.
Four of spades and three of diamonds. Take it! I thought you were bluffing.
Cleveland, I can't shake the feeling I've forgotten something.
Where's your wife?
Oh, my God!
Emma!
Oh, look who's here! I didn't think we'd see you till Chicago.
Fanny thought we could go over the new material if we took the train together.
She'll be right along. John, can you take care of Miss Bryce's luggage, please?
Fanny, I know, packs some liquor crates and a pillowcase.
I got these last month.
Monogrammed? How long has Arnstein been around?
He's been with us since Baltimore, but he's not coming to Chicago.
She's a grown woman. She can do what she likes.
It appears you're taking all of Cleveland with you, Miss Bryce.
Ah, I never want to leave. It's the most beautiful city in the world. Oh, I wish you were coming with us.
I was going to surprise you, but now I can't. You were there at the track. Elsie lost her race, and I lost Elsie and my shirt.
Not the ruffled one.
No, darling, I'll never lose that one, nor my gambling money. Just about everything else.
But why Monte Carlo?
Because it's filled with casinos, which are filled with bored businessmen who've nothing to do but play cards.
And Chicago's got a shortage of businessmen.
I've let you sideline my circuit far too long. After Monte Carlo, I have London and Dublin. By then, it'll be racing season again. That's my life.
But it don't gotta be. Gambling, I mean, with your brains and talent, you could be anything. You could be a regular gentleman farmer breeding world-class racehorses, or there's that California oil deal you keep talking about.
Fanny, you've known who I am since that first night on Henry Street.
I know. I know that all by heart. I was just talking is all, and you don't have to worry. You're not involved.
6 a.m. to New York, now leaving on track 12. Final boarding.
That's me.
How can you walk in, change my whole life, and walk right out again?
And I promise to walk right back in as soon as I can do it with a fortune in each hand.
Last time took a year.
This is nothing like last time.
Yeah, what's different?
I love you.
You mean it? You're not just blowing me off with some curtain line. Hey, Monte Carlo, London, Dublin. Right there, you got the makings of one hell of a honeymoon. So how about we get married?
Excuse me, but I think this is yours, Mr. Bryce.
See, even he thinks it's a good idea.
Honey, I do want to marry you. Not right now, not when I'm broke.
Ah, marry me for my money. I swear I won't be insulted.
That's exactly what people will think.
Who cares?
I do. This is going to be my way or not at all.
Yes, Mr. Arnstein. Whatever you say, Mr. Arnstein, but you did say you were going to marry me.
Yes.
Last call. Train to New York, leaving on track 12.
And you said you love me.
I'll call.
And write.
Goodbye, Fanny.
Vera! Oh, look at that face! You might be the first person in history sorry to leave Cleveland. You ever do that? You ever turn your back and let what you want walk away? More times than I can remember. I can't. I can't do that.
Listen, kid, you're gonna die every time you say goodbye to a man.
Where's Emma? Emma?
Yes, Fanny.
Get my luggage off that train. I'm not going to Chicago.
What?
And book me on the next train to New York.
Just where do you think you're going?
To Monte Carlo with Nick Arnstein.
He asked you alone?
No, but he'll be glad to see me, I hope.
So you're just gonna throw yourself at him?
I love the man and I want to be with him.
And you think he loves you?
Is that so impossible?
Get her bags to track 16!
Miss Bryce! Have you forgotten you're on tour with this show?
You'll be fine. You've got 5 other top names to fill in.
You're being completely selfish and ungrateful and unprofessional.
Simmer down, Flo, before your ulcer starts flaring up.
Oh, that's funny coming from you. You gave me this ulcer.
Listen, Flo, I love you. I love the theater. I love the audience, but I can't take them home with me. I want a life, too.
Fanny, if you do this, I am through with you. And I mean it.
Fanny, you're making a fool of yourself.
This is right for me.
But is it right for Nick?
I'll make it right for him.
Oh, Fanny, take my advice and don't.
Don't tell me not to live, just sit and watch. If someone takes a spill, it's me and not you. Who told you you're a clown to rain on my parade? How much my band knows, I'll be my drum. And if I'm fanned out, your turn at that, sir. At least I didn't fake it half, sir. I
Hey, Mr. Einstein, here I am. I tried my fan. Your turn at bat, sir. At least I didn't think it had, sir. I guess I didn't make.
Can we discuss this after I've had a little sleep?
Yeah, sure, of course.
Thank you, Sadie. Very thoughtful.
Did you just call me Sadie?
Oh, did I not mention what a good night I had at the tables?
Corporation now, not me myself now.
year guarantee.
Paul, sit me in the softest seat. Quick, a cushion for my feet. Do for me, buy for me, lift me, carry me. Finally got a guy to marry me. I do my nails, read up on sales. All day, the records play. Then he comes home, I tell him, boy, what a day I had today. I swear I'll do my wifely job. Just sit at home, become a slob.
Why not? She wasn't exactly born into a family of no talents. I
cut a pretty decent rug in my day.
And she always had me to show her the ropes. But do I ever get a bow?
Well, at least she got you a good job. What am I but a built-in babysitter?
My work is done. My work is done.
Our work is done. She doesn't need us. She'll have cake. We'll have crumbs. Be careful of the stage door. Here she comes. Here she comes. Hello, Fanny. Hello.
Hello, Fanny. It's me, Mama.
What do you mean, Mama who?
It's good to see her from afar. And who taught her everything she knows? I taught her everything she knows. She sings like a bird, yes indeed. But who used to stand there and feed her to see? Who taught her how to pick her clothes?
Any that I get.
Who taught her how to tap her toes? Well, she admitted, kid, you said it. They all forget to know y'all when it comes to credit. Tell me, have you ever seen her take this pose? I taught her everything, how to hoop and how to sing. I taught her everything she knows.
Wings. Maybe an escalator.
There's a driver at the door. Someone called for a taxi?
That would be for me. Could you ask him to wait, please?
You going to the city?
Philadelphia. Actually, just a train to Philadelphia. I got a tip from a friend. There's a group of investors passing through on the way to Philly. You know that I'm desperate to nab investors for my Florida project.
But you promised. Today's my first day of rehearsal. What am I supposed to do?
24 hours there and back, you'll never know I'm gone. Rosie, you'll hold the fort down for me, won't you?
Sure thing.
I don't think you should go.
And I don't want to go, but darling, business is business.
Nick, I mean, I'm starting the new show today. I'm leaving little Francis for the first time. I'm nervous enough as it is. You can't do this to me.
You got Mrs. Carlson and Emma and your mother.
Absolutely.
See, not a worry in the world.
This is not what we talked about.
You said that if I went back to work, you would be here.
24 hours? Not even.
You're right. Go. I'm being ridiculous. You go ahead. I'll stay home. Maybe I decided to go back to work too soon. I'll call Flo and I'll tell him that I just can't.
Fanny, can I get you help with something in the kitchen?
Mama, please stay out of this.
Fanny?
It's all right, Rose. It's fine. If that's what Fanny wants, I'll tell the cab to go.
Thank you. What? I gotta get to the theater. Mwah.
See you.
How's the baby?
Oh, you got some nerve asking him about the baby. You haven't been out to see her in weeks.
Maybe he's been busy.
He could ask me about the baby.
All right, how's the baby?
The baby, don't ask. Eddie, tell Flo how pretty she is.
The cutest little girl in the world.
She's pretty, right? She's pretty?
Very pretty, fam.
Made no mistake hiring him.
So tell me, Nick, how are the horses running?
I guess you haven't heard. Nick's gambling days are over.
Somebody hold me up. Nick Armstein's quit the track.
After all these years, I finally had to admit, do what I may, the percentages will always be on the side of the house. So from now on...
May I present the house?
I'm buying up half of Florida, the smaller half, and opening the most luxurious gambling casino in the world.
Has he got it upstairs in the head, my fella?
He better have it downstairs in the pocketbook.
I actually dropped by hoping to run into you, Flo.
Me?
This is a once-in-a-lifetime deal I'm putting together.
Sounds expensive.
Actually, my biggest problem is keeping the wrong money out. I want to control the flow of everything on the up and up. That's why I'm making this offer to only a few of my closest friends.
I'm flattered, Nick, but I do all my gambling on the stage.
Oh, there's no gamble here, Flo. Have a look if there ever was a sure
thing.
Maybe
next time.
Opportunities like this don't fall into your lap every day. Now,
sorry, Nick.
Flo! Why don't I leave the papers with you? Maybe you can have a look on your own.
Could you two tycoons discuss this some other time on account of I need a word with the father of my child?
Of course, dear.
Eddie. Nick, what are you doing?
Fanny, I need money. They're pouring the foundations for the casino as we speak. I need investors and I need them now. If I can't go out of town to tap my usual money people...
Who needs money people when you got me?
You.
What's wrong with me? What am I, a kept woman? Listen, mister, it's our money. If we got a real marriage, then what's mine is yours. So do we or don't we got a real marriage?
Of course.
So we got a deal.
Fanny, it's $68,000 cash.
You know a good divorce lawyer. I'm in, okay? You said $68,000.
Yes.
Okay, partner.
Please, Fanny, don't hold so tight. Give me some air and some light. Somehow I'm lost, really lost. Somewhere the wires got crossed. You've got to just set her straight. Hold Nikki, run Nikki! Wait. All right, you're a partner. Hey, Mr. Arnstein, here's fortunes of fickle dame. Haven't run into them lately, but both of them know my name. It's a temporary estrangement from the crystal dish and the silver knife. But there's another side.
Me.
You check the mezzanine bar?
Everywhere. But you'll be pleased to know there's not a ticket to be had. Not even standing room. How does it feel to be a hit before you step on the stage?
Something's wrong. He's never missed an opening night.
The guy's full of surprises. I'm not prying or nothing, but things okay with you two?
Couldn't be better. He just got back from Miami, checking in on the casino, came back on top of the world.
You didn't have to write another check?
Stop. You don't like him and you never have.
It's your opening night and where's he?
He'll be here.
As long as you're making the big bucks, he will.
You and I have been together a long time, so I'm gonna let that one slip.
I didn't mean... I have this bad habit of worrying about you.
Break it.
All I'm saying is you work so hard for everything you have.
And hard work is all I ever got back. I used to wonder, when does the fun begin? When do the clowns come on?
But then the fabulous, magical Nick Arnstein showed up and the party began.
I got a dress. Where the hell is Emma? Nikki?
Just stop by to say how wonderful it is to have you back with us, dear.
Thank you, Flo.
Break a leg, dear.
Flo, one more thing. You didn't happen to see Nick out there, did you?
Sorry, dear. I'll keep an eye out for it.
Thank you. No luck. I covered every racetrack, police station.
Did you try the hospitals?
Don't be so dramatic.
People get hit by cars all day long, don't they? He could be lying in the street somewhere, Emma.
Annie, you're getting yourself...
Emma, please! I'll call the hospital, but you've got to get on stage!
Come on. Time for the clowns.
Tell him.
The important thing is you're right. Talk, children. Don't holler. Talk.
First sign of a fight and you're playing to an empty house. So you want to tell me why you ruined my opening night?
I'm sure your audience didn't suffer because of me.
Oh, damn right they didn't. But how do you think I felt out there, trying to be funny, wondering if you were laying dead in the street and you don't even care enough to let me know you're okay?
I don't care.
Not enough to be here.
You know what? The hell with you in your opening night. I lost everything today. Everything I've been working for. God said, Nick, my friend, things are going too good for you. I can't have that. So he sent a big wind and he blew it all to hell.
What are you talking about?
A hurricane. A hurricane hit Florida and wiped me right off the map! Gone! All of it! My casino, my money, your money, it's gone!
Nikki, and I hollered at you.
I didn't want to tell you before the show. Anyhow, I needed a few drinks, a little time to think.
What's to think? Even the great Nick Arnstein can't control the weather.
You're not listening. We're wiped out. Broke!
So we're broke. We got our health, and little Francis and each other. And I know you didn't lose your ruffled shirt because I got that hit so good, Sherlock Holmes couldn't find it. You're Nick Arnstein. 2 weeks, you'll be back on top.
And what if I'm not? What are you going to do, write another check?
Why not? What's mine is yours. Hell, without you, I'd still be singing to drunks back at Keeney's.
Stop patronizing me!
All right. But you're gonna have to tell me what that means first. Nikki, please don't walk out on me. Let me help you. You do so much for me. What do I ever get to do for you? Who are you now? Stronger for my touch, am I giving to the world?
Agency with a sophisticated profile that will attract the most prestigious clients.
Well, why me? I've never negotiated a theatrical deal.
Well, every time I describe what I'm looking for, someone with personal stature and important theatrical contacts, your name comes up.
Well, that's very flattering, but
you gotta come see, there's a rabbit chasing two dogs. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to come barging in.
I'm glad you did, darling. This is Mr. Rinaldi, who seems to be making me an offer.
Oh, well, if it's a big fat offer, it's a pleasure, Mr.
Rinaldi. And I am a great admirer of yours, Mrs. Arnstein.
Darling, Mr. Rinaldi is opening a theatrical agency and wants me to go in with him.
Oh, well, that's a new idea.
At first, I thought he was just trying to get to you, but he knows you're with another agency, so it seems he wants me for myself.
Well, I think he'd make a terrific agent, Mr. Rinaldi.
As do I.
After all, I've been a gambler, a promoter, a salesman.
Oh, with a real-life talent. He was the first person to discover me in a burlesque house.
And here's the best part, darling.
Thank you.
Mr. Rinaldi is offering a full partnership without a penny of my investment.
Well, as I said, I've got the money. What I need from you is that air of distinction that you'd bring to the enterprise.
That's some pricey air.
That's the offer.
It's very generous. It's too generous. Fanny, how much money did you put into the agency?
20 grand.
A bargain after the 68 I lost last year. Good afternoon, Mr. Rinaldi. I'm sorry your time has been wasted.
Well, you can't blame a girl for trying. Nick, I'm so sorry.
Annie, you promised. You promised and then you did it again.
I only thought that with the right break.
Fanny! I'm not a child. You can't pay the babysitter to keep me amused.
I was only trying to help.
No one asked for your help! I got along just fine before you and I can get along! Just leave it alone, Fanny. I'm begging you, please, leave it alone.
I'm sorry, but the car is here. You've got that photo shoot for Life magazine before the radio show.
Go, you'll be late.
So I'll be late.
You can't be late. How could the world get along without Fanny Bryce making with the funny? It's all right. It's fine. It'll be fine. Go. If you want thing, honey, you're a funny girl. You constantly have me
is double in half. And though you may be all wrong for a guy, you're good for a laugh. I tell you though, honey, you don't seem so funny. Beekman 4119. Tom Leflin. Hello, Lefty. Nick Arnstein. Good, good. Are you still trying to peddle that fancy bond deal? Because I'm in a listening mood these days. Risky. Well, that don't bother me so long as it's profitable. I'll need $68,000 in advance. Well, let's put it this way. You got the 68 grand, and risk or no risk, you got me. Good. I'll be there. Well, to me, it ain't so funny. Funny.
On, it was a phony.
No, Nick's too smart for that. Let me give my lawyer a call.
Nick's got a lawyer. Bill Fallon.
Fallon's a criminal attorney.
Embezzlement's a criminal charge.
It doesn't look too good, honey.
No. With Fallon, he'll look guilty. Let me call my guy, please.
Stop, Marie!
Oh, I can fix this!
You can't. It's done. He's in jail.
How do you know when I don't? Why didn't he come to me?
He's humiliated, Fanny. He can't face you.
What's he got to be ashamed of? He got fooled is all.
Are you sure about that?
You don't think he knew the deal was crooked?
He knew. He did. He knew.
Why? I don't believe it. Why would he do something like that? Money. We don't need money.
He needed money. He needed his own money. Fanny, what you doing to him with your handouts? You're choking the life out of him as sure as wrapping your fingers around his throat.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Your father charmed his way into any job he fancied. But could he keep one? I didn't give a damn. I kept up the saloon, which kept him, and I couldn't care less about anything else. So whatever foolishness he got himself into, it didn't matter to me. But Fanny, a person wants to matter. You can't make someone feel that small.
I didn't do it to make him feel small.
You did it because you love him, but you should have loved him less and respected him more. You should have let him be himself.
I love Nick Arnstein for exactly who he is.
Are you sure about that, huh? Exactly who he is? A crook? An embezzler?
Mama!
It had to be said, I'm sorry, but that's who he's always been.
I have to see him.
Give the dust a minute to settle.
The lawyer say how long he could get?
Could be 5 years. 3, with luck. Call me, honey. Call me anything. Goodbye, Benny.
Go on, I know you're dying to say something horrible about him.
You want to cancel the show tonight? The reporters are going to descend in droves.
And I bet not one of them says that Nick Arnstein was an honest man until he married me.
Whatever makes a good story.
It'll be news every time I visit him in prison.
He should have thought of that before he did this to you.
Oh, Eddie. You have no idea what Nick did for me. Just leave me alone, please. I add two and two, the most simple addition, and swear that the figures align. I'm much better comic than mathematician, 'cause I'm better on stage than at intermission. I've been burned. I haven't. refreshed and good as new. You've been sitting here all this time? Just doing the math. Come up with the right answer. Is there a right answer? Will you see Mr. Ziegfeld? He's outside. Come on in, Flo.
This is it?
The night Nick Arnstein gets sprung from the clink? This is it.
You haven't been up to see him?
At first I went, but he didn't really want me there, and I...
You've spoken to him?
Not yet.
John, just call 5 minutes to places.
I'll set your props.
Then let you dress.
Flo, one more thing? I want to do this his way from now on, you understand? Whatever he says goes. So if that means giving up the theater and staying home, I hope you'll be a sport about it.
Why don't we worry about that when it happens? Have a great show, dear.
Come on, you ain't got no words of advice.
You know that however I act, whatever I say, it's because, to me, you are special. I thought it that first day at Keeney's, and man, was I right. Look at you. You're Fanny Bryce.
I couldn't have done it without you.
I wouldn't go that far.
Will you just shut up and take the compliment?
Be happy, my friend. Be happy.
Hello, Fanny.
You must be that fella in my bikinis.
You must be that funny girl.
Did you go by the house?
No, I didn't stop to see the baby. I came straight here. I guess she's not such a baby anymore.
Wait till you see her, Nick. She's becoming this little lady. And she's gorgeous, just like you. Who says I'm not lucky? Oy, I feel like a kid on a blind date. You as scared as me.
Fanny, I've had 3 years to think.
Nick, before you go on, I've had the same 3 years to go over and over what happened, and I know how much of it was my fault, how many stupid fucked-up things I did. But I can change. I know I can, I promise you.
I'm sorry, Fanny. People don't change. Not really. Haven't we knocked each other around enough? Let's call it off before one of us can't get back up again.
Wow. I mean, wow! Am I glad you stopped me? You should have heard the rest of that speech. I've been rehearsing it for weeks.
Fanny.
Nick, I swear I was just telling you what I thought you wanted to hear, but really, I feel the same way as you.
You mean that?
Of course I do. Boy, am I glad we don't have to get all tragic about this. If we both want the same thing, then ending it is a good thing, wouldn't you say? A lot of it was awfully good. You gotta admit. You did a lot for me, Nick. That's what I'm gonna remember.
What did I do for you, darling? What did I give you that you couldn't have gotten for yourself?
Our daughter. And only you would have given me a blue marble leg. And you made me feel almost sort of beautiful.
You are beautiful. I practically had to fight my way through the crowds of people who come to see you. You shouldn't keep them waiting. Goodbye, Fanny.
funny. Yeah, the guy said, honey, you're a funny girl. That's me, I just keep on in stitches. Doubled in half. And though I may be all wrong, I'm good for a while. I guess it's not funny. Life is far from sunny. When the laugh is over and the joke's on me, a girl ought to have a sense of humor. That's one thing you really need for sure when you're a funny girl. The fella said, I didn't fake it.